Hi there, my name is Dan. Now there are loads of videos here like this one on my channel, but if you want more, check out my website, bringyourownlaptop.com. Hey there, my name's Dan. In this video, we're gonna look at kind of creating the matrix effect using time remapping. Now, it's not really the matrix effect. It's just that kind of like cool slow-mo things kind of look like they're bending bullet type thing. Okay, so let's go and do that. Let's bring in a video. Okay, so in our After Effects files here, we've got one in here called time remapping. Where is he? Why can't I see it? There it is, time remapping. And let's make a comp from it, new comp. Okay, and there it is down here. That's a skateboarder. Okay, doing a kickflip. And what we wanna do now is we wanna do a couple of things. Say let's forget the matrix thing, you just wanna speed it up or slow it down. Okay, what you can do is with it selected down here, you can go to layer, go to time. There's one here called time stretch. Okay, and all it does is say it's 28 seconds and you wanna cut it down to say 10, okay? It's gonna shrink it right down, okay? You could drag either the percentage or the time, okay? So I'm gonna make this a lot quicker. So you can see it shorten it up and watch, he's walking, he's going a lot faster. And bam. Okay, but that's not what I wanna do. So I want edit undo. So that's what, if you wanna just speed it up or slow it down. What we wanna do is a bit more, when he gets to his kickflip, okay, so I want him to go quite fast, but when he gets to his kickflip, it goes, I want it to get it really slow about here. Okay, so let's go and do that. And the thing is called time remapping. So with the layer selected, okay, we're gonna go to layer, time, there's one there called enable time remapping. Nothing really happens, you get a couple of keyframes either side for you, and this little thing called time remap. So what we want to do now is you leave those two keyframes alone, and what you want to do is put two keyframes either side of the thing. In this case, it's him doing a kickflip. So I'm going to have it just about here. Okay, I'm going to force a keyframe in by clicking the little diamond. Then just afterwards, drag my playhead just about when he lands and put in another keyframe. Okay, then what we want to do is drag them apart. So think of this as one long rubber band, and we're going to grab it and stretch between these two points here. Okay, and what happens is that gets stretched out and goes slow, and these bits here get a bit slack because they're joining up, and it goes a bit faster in these bits. So I'm gonna preview it now. It's not gonna look beautiful just yet, okay, and there's a couple of other things we need to do, but just get a sense of what's happening. He's cruising along. I should really trim up this video, it's a bit long. But then when he gets to here, it launches into slow-mo. Really bad slow-mo, I understand. And there's two things we need to do to make this look nice. First of all, is we need to change these diamonds, because at the moment it just kind of launches into slow-mo. The way to kind of ease it into it, you can hold down, if you're on a PC, hold down the control key. If you're on a Mac, on the command key, and just click these. It's an easy way to add a bit of blending between these two keyframes. So it's gonna, instead of just launching into it, it's gonna slowly get into it. Still not very nice. Okay, but at least it's not just like suddenly becoming slow. So that's gonna do the first part. The next bit is something called frame blending. Now frame blending is, at the moment what it's doing is it's, because it's slowing it down, it's just like pulling the frames apart, and it's going really slow. So jump, 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 jump. What we can tell After Effects is be a bit more clever and blend the frames to make this kind of like composite thing. To do that, we need to do, it's kind of like motion blur. You need to turn it on globally, okay? And then you need to turn it on per layer. Turn it on globally, and then down here, can you see this layer here has out the same option? And this one here has two options. Motion blur just has one, on and off. This one here has one, two, and off. So one, two, off, one, two, off. In this case, you trial with both depending on your footage, okay? Generally though, the second one here. So first one, no, second one, yes. Okay, it's this one here called this frame blending. Okay, so that one there tends to do a better job. It's gonna take a little bit long to render. I'm gonna start mine here so it's not far away. Watch this, hit spacebar. Now it should do more of that kind of matrixy. Nice. Does some weird things with the lights, but it's kind of cool. Okay, now it depends on how far, where your keyframes were, how far apart you've had them. Say you find it's maybe take a bit long. It did take a bit long, didn't it? So I'm twirling these in here, move them a bit closer so it's not as extreme. So it's slow. but a whole lot nicer than without the frame blending. If I turn it off globally, jumpity jump jump. Okay, frame blending on, smooth. All right, that's how to use time remapping and kind of make that matrixy slow down type effect.